Let's be real for a second. You're probably not ready for the AI revolution, but that is completely fine because most people, including me, are just figuring these things out as we go. The key thing to keep in mind while we enter this new phase of human technological progress is that you need to keep your eyes open and be ready to adjust fast. Easier said than done. But the good news is that by you watching this very video, you're already in the camp of people that are actively seeking this knowledge, which puts you in the right side of history. Now, all we need to do together is to figure out what these changes are gonna be so we can adjust in time. And that's exactly what this video is about. I'm gonna tell you about some of the biggest trends that are going to develop in AI over the course of 2023. So once they hit, you're ready. So stay tuned to find out how AI is changing the game behind the scenes today and in public very, very soon. So here's my list of 7 AI predictions that will unfold over 2023. And the first one comes from a currently nascent giant in the space, Meta/Facebook. It's no secret that they've been struggling over the past 2 years. With their refocus to the metaverse and not much to show for it yet, they're falling behind a lot of these other tech companies that own the platforms that the internet is happening on today. And that's why they need to keep up in AI here. They can't just watch from the sidelines. That is very clear. And they have definitely been working behind the scenes here. One thing I want to show you is the next big thing in AI once it's ready. It's AI generated video. I mean, it only makes sense. Now we're able to generate images and text, and all video is 24 images per second. Now, obviously, it's exponentially more complicated than images, but now that we have images, it's not unthinkable anymore, right? So here's a Verge article where they showed off some of their AI generated videos that their very own in-house AI is producing. Are these amazing? No, and that's why they're not public yet. This is just a glimpse of the future. But I personally can't think of a bigger game changer for the content creation industry than this feature coming out. Stock footage? Why would I ever use that again if I can custom generate every single clip I need with a few clicks? Now, to be fair, we might not see this in 2023 yet because it's just so early and this is a very hard problem to solve. But I do think they'll be rushing to market with some AI product and maybe we'll see early demos. But what we see already, and most people don't know about this, is this diplomacy bot developed by Meta/Facebook. So the funny thing about this one is in all the tests, it can outmaneuver people in a complex game like diplomacy, where it's always about finding compromises and giving something up to achieve your goals. And the whole thing is about predicting humans' next moves, as maybe a computer would do when it plays chess. The funny thing about this is, in the game of diplomacy, there is no constraints or rules like chess, right? Or very little. So keep your eyes open for Meta coming out with game-changing technology here, because as you might know, one of the most valuable things in this game is the data set you train the AI on, and Meta has one of the most interesting and unique data sets in the world. Between Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp, they know a lot more about human behavior than maybe any other company in the world. And as you can see with these examples, they're clearly not asleep at the wheel. My next prediction here, which is actually less of a prediction and more of a thing that already started happening, is this copyright mess that we got ourselves into with all this AI tech. The way these models function is that they learn from a bunch of data, and then there's a layer of human interaction that teaches the code what's good and what's less good. But the fact remains that at the end of the day, every single one of these outputs is just a remix of some other data. And with art, this is getting a lot of people pissed off, and rightfully so. Imagine all your life you've been perfecting your craft, and then you develop a unique style, and all of a sudden this thing reads it, and just by including your name, it can create infinite amounts of work just in the style that you've been developing all your life. Well, that really sucks, and some people are standing up and protesting already. As in this example that popped up a few days ago, a bunch of artists got together and are targeting Midjourney with a copyright lawsuit, as they're claiming that all their outputs are plagiarized from other artists' work. But then also everything I'm saying right now is kind of a remix of everything I've heard and learned throughout my life, right? But on the latter example, we have clear regulations and laws in place that govern this. With AI, not so much so. So this year is going to be very messy when it comes to fleshing out some of these laws. So just be extra careful whenever you use AI output, and just be aware that some of these rights could maybe be retroactively took away from you. But honestly, this topic touches the art and imagery side more than it does text. Just be aware that's something that is happening. But now let's talk about GPT-4. Now, this was a massive story over the past few weeks, right? This data is not confirmed, by the way, but it has been going viral all over socials. So on the left, you can see GPT-3, the model that ChatGPT is based on. It's GPT-3.5. But essentially, this is how many data points it's based upon right now. And on the right, you can see how much information GPT-4 consumed to be trained. A metric ton squared more. So is it gonna be that much better? We don't know. Is this accurate? We don't know. None of this has been confirmed by OpenAI, but the fact is GPT-4 is going to use all of the data that we have been inputting into ChatGPT on a daily basis. I mean, heck, just with the amount of experimentation I've done myself, they're gonna be able to train one hell of a content creation bot. But again, I always just use it as inspiration. Just like every video I'm free-flowing off a few bullet points here. All I do is use it for research extensively. But the point being, GPT-4 is going to be ridiculous, and we just don't know how ridiculous. This is just an estimate. estimate. But at the end of the day, it's not just going to have all the data we're training it with right now, but it might just have access to the internet. Again, we don't know, but as the competition heats up over the course of the year, some of these players will be forced to plug this into the internet and to give the consumers the best possible product in order to compete. So keep your eyes peeled and make sure to hit those notification settings, because I'll be pumping out content like my life depends on it once this comes out. And talking about content, let's talk about AI-generated content that will definitely be another big trend happening this year. Music, books, and movies, where at the very least the script is generated by AI, but in the case of movies, you could easily write an entire movie script with AI and then generate storyboards with Midjourney that you could then reenact. And I'm sure I'm not the first person to think of this. It's a massive opportunity to create the first fully AI-generated movie, right? And I'm sure people are working on this, and not just working, rushing, because some of these opportunities will only be really valuable when you're the first one to do it. If you're second, you might as well be 200th. And that's why I think we're gonna see our first AI-generated movie in 2023. Now, on the way easier side is generating books or musical symphonies with AI, right? You have these voice generators that are really good in the case of some artists, and then people are plugging this new tech into all types of software. And I think this is one of the big opportunities of the year, because the attention is there. People are really curious. Wow, AI, okay, what can it do? What can it do for me? It actually generated this image. Wow, that's an AI-generated song. That's actually really good. All of this is a novelty. Novel things that are useful naturally spark a human's attention, right? So I see a ton of opportunities happening across all of media, YouTube included. If you know how to use this thing, just the level of quality you're able to deliver as a content creator is unmatched if you're using some of these tools to research and prepare your videos. And before we move on to the next one, I want to talk about AI-powered games, which are way further down the line, obviously, but it's years, not decades, right? And what I mean by that is like these role-playing games where every character has like a ChatGPT built in, and when you talk to it, it has a legit personality and can answer any question, and not just one of five questions that you get to pick from. As an avid gamer and concretely RPG enjoyer, I can't wait for the moment when I plug into one of these worlds that are actually alive, where you can use a mic to communicate with the characters around you. Now, if you take that even a step further and do an MMORPG, you're gonna have a bunch of human characters, and then all of these NPCs are gonna have personalities of their own that can actually interact with you. But that's a whole different rabbit hole to go down, but I would expect Meta to be at the forefront of this, because their entire metaverse idea is kind of like an MMORPG on steroids. And if you add this AI tech into, let's say, interactive NPCs, you're quickly gonna get products that we've just never seen before. And that leads me to the next one, which is a very important one, and that is that many scams are gonna pop up around this entire topic. And it just makes sense. We're entering uncharted territory. People don't know what to expect, and therefore they're more vulnerable to malicious actors. And honestly, we're already seeing this all across the content space. And if you look at all these new AI apps, a lot of them are either on the edge of the gray zone, or in my books, even beyond that gray zone, where it's just a clear grift. I mean, putting up an app in the Android App Store where you simply plug ChatGPT into it and charge $8 a month, in my books, is not fine. Even a member of my family just sent me a video of, wow, look at this amazing AI app. It's just $8 a month and you can refer friends to get free credits. And all it is ChatGPT with like a graphical user interface. I mean, fair enough, that one is still in the gray zone because it gives you the added value of some of these presets, but you might as well watch videos like this and find out about them yourselves and save your $8 for something more meaningful. So just be on the lookout for scams and fake experts increasingly streaming into the space, as the hype around this tech is very, very real, but for a good reason. This is actually game-changing technology, which we need to master and not ignore. And that brings me to my next point, and that is the rise of prompt engineers. Now, if you're still not familiar with the prompt, that is essentially the question you put into the AI so it generates an answer. And what I see already happening is people that are advanced with their prompting getting a serious advantage over the people that completely ignore this. And yes, just simply integrating ChatGPT into your daily workflows gives you an advantage over everybody else. That's just a fact. But what I mean with this prediction is that people that go deeper and become advanced at prompting some of these becoming invaluable assets to a lot of businesses. Think of it like a consultant with 40 years of experience, because once you're able to ask the right questions, these language models will deliver answers that go beyond anything that a human could come up with in just seconds. A true superpower. And as you might know, this entire channel is based around teaching you those superpowers so you can get the advantage you deserve. And at this point, I just have to point out that I have an ebook that will help you get towards that. And all that ebook is my very best attempt at teaching you how to ask the right questions. By the way, I'm creating a short video training that will be free for everybody that buys the book. Plus, you get all future updates for free. But now let's talk about my last prediction for this year. And this one I actually got from this incredible podcast. You might be familiar. It's called The All In Podcast. And on the latest episode. They just had one of the highest quality discussion around the state of AI today. And if you enjoyed this video, I bet that you would love that conversation. And what they brought up is that AI might turn into a commodity over the course of the next year here. Now, what that means is that so many competitors are going to enter the market in 2023 that OpenAI will not remain the only cool kid on the block. With major players like Google, Microsoft, Nvidia, and Facebook entering the game here soon, we will witness a literal race to deliver killer apps. And Google is the wild card here because they are already king in the category of search. And in the podcast, they brought up the fascinating topic of how Google is actually the one interested in scorching the earth, as they said, aka releasing a model to the public, which sets all things equal and allows them to remain king. In other words, there's massive incentives at play at making this freely available, just like Stable Diffusion is right now with AI art generation. And once it's freely available, everyone can build on it and everybody can integrate it. And if all these language models are at one level, Google will still have the upper hand with the best search because they're number one already. And this kind of brings together all the predictions we've been talking about here. Because if these companies are going to be one-upping each other and bringing things to market faster and better, at the end of the year, we're going to find out that it was a fantastic year for the consumer. You and me, we're going to get to use a lot of this cutting-edge tech. In the 90s, for example, a lot of the best technology was protected and safeguarded by companies like IBM, and they profited from all the benefits. But here, if you keep your eyes open and you stay up to date with all the latest things in AI, there's a realistic chance of you getting that advantage, the AI advantage. All right, so if you want to take action now, there's this video that you can watch that will teach you some of these techniques that will get you ahead of everybody ignoring this giga trend. See you there.